The books of the Bible lead us to revival. Name them one by one. See what God has done. Genesis, Exodus, Leviticus, Numbers, Deuteronomy. Joshua, Judges, Ruth, 1st and 2nd Samuel, 1st and 2nd Kings. 1st and 2nd Chronicles, Ezra, Nehemiah.
Question for you guys. When you walk into a dark room, what is the first thing that you do? Do you yell out to see if anybody's there? Do you move your hands around and try to figure out where you're going? Or do you turn on a light? Yeah, me too. I turn on the light. It'd be easy for us to trip over something or to fall down if we don't have light to light our path so we can see what's ahead of us. It's so helpful. Something kind of we take for granted, right? Street lights help cars to stay on the road. The lights of the car also when it's dark outside, right? Flashlights when you're out doing like a corn maze of an evening, or if you're sitting by a fire roasting marshmallows, it helps you to see where you're going and see what you're doing. Even stars and the moon help us at night, right? They provide some light. Light is a gift from God, part of His creation, right? So, did you know that the Word of God is a light? Think about that for a minute. It's a different thought, that the Word of God, His Word, His Bible, that He's given us, those words are a light. In Psalm 119, it says, "Your word is a lamp to my feet and a light to my path." King David wrote these words in the longest chapter of the Bible. You have to look that up. Psalm 119 is the longest chapter in the Bible. It's filled with phrase after phrase, words after words that celebrate the word of God. David understood that when everything feels dark, God speaks and it lights up the darkness. It's like flipping on the light switch. Just like a lamp laid at your feet, lighting the path in front of you, the road in front of you, God's word is a light that shows our way through life. I've talked a lot to you guys about how God's word is like our handbook for life, okay? It gives us things that we should do. It gives us promises that God always keeps. And it gives us things that we shouldn't do to help us lead a healthy, growing life. So the next time that you can't figure out the right way to go, or you can't tell what God wants you to do, where do you think you should look? Should you look to your friends for the answer? Or should you turn on the TV and see if someone on TV can give you the answer? Or do you think maybe you should go to the Bible and see what God has to say? Now, we'll tell you, Bible's a great handbook for life, but it doesn't say to us every single detail of what we should and shouldn't do. It was written so many years ago. But if we read the whole Bible, and if we think about the whole plan that God has given us, then it is our guidebook. It gives us just the right things for us to know the next step that we should take. It gives us just the right amount of light so that we can keep moving forward and moving toward God. So, a couple things for you to think about this week, okay? First, I want you to check out Psalm 119. I love the book of Psalms. It's full of praise and worship. It's got some great prayers in it. You know, I like it because a lot of these were sung as songs. A lot of the Psalms were. But I want you to check it out. It's right in the middle of the Bible. It's easy to find. Look up Psalm 119, the longest chapter in the Bible. King David wrote it. And try to find Psalm 119, verse 105. Your word is a lamp to my feet and a light to my path. So that's the first thing I want you to do. The second thing I want you to do is try to be a light for your friends. Think about ways that you can bring some light to their lives, maybe by being kind. Maybe if somebody does something that hurts you, maybe by forgiving them and helping to move forward. Maybe it is at home, going out of your way to be a helper and to be responsible and be part of a team at your house. So think about some ways that you can be a light, okay? Now that we're talking about how God is our light, how can we reflect his light into our world? A fun activity that you could try, this is a great time of year for this, is to go on an evening walk. You know, it's getting dark about 7 o'clock, a little bit after. And so maybe set out with your family, one of your parents, make sure you have an adult, but take a flashlight with you and shine it in front of you and be thinking about as you're walking along and that light is lighting your path about how God's light, his word, shines a path in our path for each one of us. It's great to be with you guys this morning. It's been so good to see some of you around church and out in, around the town. And I hope you are doing well. And I hope to see you all again soon. Have a great day.
Arise, my soul. For I was dead in sin, but I
please.